difference between accounts, accounting and accountancy?
Accounts means the report.
Okay.
Which we are doing. Accountancy is proper doing that report.
Okay.
Like we are recording that thing.
Right.
And accountancy, I don't remember that.
Okay. Go through it. Okay, you stated that you are a commercial, so definitely we'll ask you some commercial terms like capital budgeting.
Yes,
what
sir.
Does it mean?
Capital budgeting means when a person or company want to invest something, like we are purchasing a machinery, then where should we invest that money? If we are purchasing that machinery, they will give us return. Like this will be in years. Like first year they are giving 1 lakh. Like cost of the machinery is 3 lakh rupees, and in first year their capital inflow will be, cash inflow will be 1 lakh. Second year that will be 50,000, and third year that will be 1,50,000. We will check what is the payback period of that, what is the NPV of that, what is the profitability index of that. We check all this in capital budgeting.
What is fiscal deficit?
Fiscal deficit is a like this is a difference between import and export.
Okay.
Like if import is more than export.
Okay. And what do you mean by the word budget?
Budget is a estimate. Estimate, we estimate before that thing will happen. We are allocating our resources for that.
Okay. So you must be having some knowledge regarding liabilities and assets and all these things.
Yes sir.
Okay. What is contingent liabilities?
Contingent liabilities are that can be paid or not. In accounting we record contingent liability in the footnote. That can be happened or not, we don't know about. We are not sure about that. In accounting, if that will not happen, we don't have to pay money about that. We don't take that. But that can be happen for loss, we record that.
What is the difference between current liabilities and current assets?
Current liabilities and current assets, like current assets is that asset which can be converted in 1 year in cash. And immediately, current liability immediately which we can have to pay.
And next one?
And current assets which we can convert in 1 year in cash.
Can you give examples of both?
Current assets is debtors, cash and stock. And current liability can be, sometimes we take bank overdraft in current liability, and creditors are also current liabilities.
Bookkeeping means what?
When recording.
Okay. Benchmarking?
Benchmarking is our, we can also consider as our competition.
Okay.
Means it's our benchmark, we will do better than this.
Okay. And break-even point means what?
Break-even point is our sale is equal to our cost.
Okay.
Means in which point we have no loss or no profit. After that
there is a word inflation. And there is one deflation. What is the difference?
Inflation is when
when the value of money goes down and the things cost come up
there.
This is inflation. Sustained increase in the general level of prices for goods and services, it is inflation controlled, measured by CPI WPI, consumer price index, which can be controlled by monetary policy and fiscal policy. Monetary policy is managed by RBI and fiscal policy is managed by our government. What do you mean by the word deflation?
Deflation is vice versa of inflation. If price of the goods come down.
Which one is more dangerous for the country? Inflation or deflation?
I think deflation is
deflation. And have you heard the word disinflation?
No sir, I don't.
It is a medicine, I can say, to control. It is not happen naturally. It is an artificial thing which is arranged by government. Okay, so you, if you want to read, you can go through that thing. There are three words like inflation, deflation and disinflation. Okay, yes, please, more questions.
Okay, tell us something about your family.
We are three members in our family, my father, my mother and me. And my father is a scrap seller of batteries and my mother is a housemaker.
Why we select only you?
First of all, I'd like to thank you for asking this question. I am punctual for my work and I have experience of this. Actually, I am a commerce graduate and I am MBA in marketing and finance, so I have experience of this. I have also experience of marketing and in banking and accounting and auditing.
What is the difference between fund flow and cash flow?
Cash flow is when we are determining cash flow, we see three things. In cash flow from operating activity, cash flow from investing activity, cash flow from financing activity. From operating activity, we saw in changing working capital. Like working capital means difference between current assets and current liabilities, what you are asking.
Okay.
Investing activity, what we are investing, that will be come or that amount is going. And financing, we are issuing debenture, we are issuing equity share, that amount will come, and if we are redemption that amount will be. That's the net amount, what is difference, that is cash.
And fund flow?
In fund flow, I don't remember actually, I was not doing that thing.
Okay. Go through it.
I was only
one. Okay. How many types of shares are?
There are two types of shares. Equity share and preference share.
Okay. Why they are called equity and why they are called preference?
Preference share, we give the preference in dividend. There is a fixed rate of dividend. In equity share, there is no fixed dividend rate. But equity share has some extra right, like they can vote in meeting AGM, but a preference share, they can't vote.
And what is the difference between debenture and dividend?
And debenture is like a loan, but dividend is a part of profit. In debenture, we pay them interest, but in equity share, we give them dividend, that is a part of profit.
Nowadays, there is a trend of mutual funds and SIP, that is systematic investment plans.
Yes.
Explain it.
Mutual fund is a pool of investment, there is a person who take money from all of the person and invest them according to that person. Or they there is return, they give them to all, distribute that money.
Okay.
To all.
And what is the difference between IPO and FPO?
IPO is when a company is issuing first time, that is IPO, initial public offering. And FPO is after that, again company is offering, that is further public offering.
What do you mean by the word FDI?
FDI is foreign direct investment.
What does it mean?
When foreign company is investing in India, that will be FDI.
Have you heard the word FII? Foreign institutional investments.
For institutional purpose, when they are investing.
Yes.
That will be FII.
What they are doing and what FDI are doing? What is the difference between their work?
FDI. In FI, I'm not sure about
FDI that. Is just entering in India and they are starting their business by manufacturing or whatever the things they are doing, make it a like company. Like. But FII are only purchasing the shares of Indian companies. They can run in within like minutes or within 2-3 days. The reason is only one, they just purchase and sell the shares.
Sure.
And that is why their money is known as hot money. This is the difference. And that is why FDI is more liable than FII. FII have no like concerns, they can run, they just have to take permission from SEBI and
they can invest
their shares and they can run in night, within night. So that is the difference. Have you heard the word LPG?
LPG?
Liberalization, privatization, and globalization.
This was happened in 1991 when Prime Minister was Narasimha Rao and Finance Minister was
Manmohan Singh. Why they made LPG? What was the reason?
That time inflation was going high and our GDP was very low. That time Manmohan Singh think that we should liberalize and globalize all the economy. That in foreign investment, investor they can invest in India.
Do you know Mr. Manmohan Singh also previously RBI governor also?
Yes, right.
You know, presently who is the governor of RBI? Yes, you should have presence of mind at all, right?
Right, sir.
Okay, you stated very well that this happened. So what do you mean by the word liberalization?
Liberalization, in India we get liberal. We give them license to our people to work for that.
liberty. Unnecessarily taxes got which were imposed were totally rescued and they went free. And what do you mean by the word privatization?
Mainly before 1991, government has only for some institute. But after that, only three institute like arms, railway, and there one more in government department and all the
others. Yes, previously there were 18. And what do you mean by the word globalization?
Before 1991, there was restriction for foreign investment investor. They can't invest in India. In globalization, now they can FDI will come. They can invest in India.
They can. It is type of integration of world economics in conditions of free flows of trade, movement of person across borders, facilitated by new technologies, for instance, communication or information. That is a part of globalization. Liberalization you have already stated, and privatization just privatizing the government things, right?
Right.
Have you heard the word negotiable act?
Yes, sir, I have heard.
Please, what do you mean by word?
Negotiable instrument. There are negotiable instruments like check, check, promissory note, demand note. There are transferable. That can be or that there are certain time period, fixed time period. Like there is check, there is three months. That check can be valid only for 3 months. Like there is promissory note. Promissory note is issued by RBI. If we have a note, a currency note, that is also promissory note. Other than RBI, only Government of India can issue a promissory note. Yes. That is a 1 rupees note which is issued by.
Yes. What is the difference between IMF and World Bank?
IMF is International Monetary Fund and World Bank.
What is the difference? Okay. To become a member of World Bank, you must be a member of
IMF.
And it concerns with short term and it comes with long term. Major difference. All others are rescued. What do you mean by the word NPA?
NPA is non performing asset.
Because this is very important for our banks. So how can it be?
If a interest due more than 90 days, that whole loan become NPA.
Okay. And what is the act which is being based on this NPA?
This is SARFAESI Act.
Can you tell the full form of SARFAESI Act?
Statutory.
No. Securitization and go through it. And what type of NPAs are there? Like one is
standard,
substandard, doubtful,
and close.
Okay. Have you heard the word about credit rating agencies?
Yes, sir, I have heard.
Can you tell me what do you mean by
credit rated agency rate the person according to the, their previous.
Is it a person or institution or country also? For everything. Now tell me few credit rating agencies.
There's few credit agencies in India like CIBIL, CRISIL,